Okay, we're live, Jim. Go ahead.
Well, welcome everyone to Redeemer United Church of Christ's Christmas Eve worship service. We are a church spiritually alive and growing, radically inclusive, and engaged in our communities. Tonight we have guests in our parking lot, guests Zooming in, and guests viewing on Facebook. My name is Jim Showalter, and I'm welcoming all of you as moderator for this evening. If you are viewing online and would like to view our bulletin for this evening, it's available as a Google document in the Zoom chat or on the Facebook posting. And of course, please take a minute to fill out our virtual Who's Where in the Chair survey located in the Zoom chat or in the Facebook comment section. You are invited, of course, to our Christmas morning service, which will be tomorrow at 10 a.m. Our service today will end with the Luminary Prairie Walk, and that will be to the music of Silent Night. We are going to attempt to show the walk to those of you viewing on Zoom and Facebook if our technology works. Our pastor this evening is, of course, the Reverend Julie Eklund, and she will begin our Christmas Eve worship. So welcome to all.
We are gathered this Christmas not as we would normally gather. We gather with masks and physically distant from our homes, our cars, our phones, our computers. We gather nevertheless to celebrate the Christ child, for nothing stops Christ from arriving. Nothing stops the star from shining. Nothing stops the glow of our hearts on Christmas. I can imagine the first Christmas was a simple one, and tonight our Christmas will be simple too. We will light the candles, we will read the story, and we will sing the songs. We begin our evening with hope, peace, joy, and love. And now I am going to be going outside, and we are going to begin our service.
Holy One, we give you thanks for our presence among us, in Jesus your child, born into a poor family.
Christ has entered our lives and embraced our hope and our struggle, showing forth the power of your love in healing, teaching, and challenging the powers of the world that lead to death.
With confidence in your faithfulness, we welcome your beloved child in our midst.
God be with us in the light of Christ.
May I offer a Christmas prayer. God of hope, peace, joy, and love, we are gathered this year under strenuous circumstances. This year we bring our grief, our loneliness, and our sadness. We are gathered unlike we have ever gathered for Christmas before. This year, unlike other years, we understand the Christmas story like we've never had in years past. We yearn for Christ's presence in our lives more than we thought we ever would. We seek your strength this day to bring joy to our sadness, to bring peace to a troubled world, to bring hope to our worried souls, and to bring love to a country so divided. Help us to see the light of the Christ child shining brightly in this world full of darkness. Help us to follow Christ's teachings and be leaders of justice, mercy, and compassion. Help us strengthen our faith so we may hear the new things you are calling us to do and the new songs you are calling us to sing and boldly take action in the name of Christ. May our actions make room for all those left out of the inn. May we confess our sins of the many times that we have closed ourselves off to you from your light, from your wisdom and your glory. May we instead be drawn to truth and live as whole people of God, dedicated to Christ and Christ's mission of love. Amen.
In those days, Caesar Augustus published a decree ordering a census of the whole Roman world. This first census took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All the people were instructed to go back to the towns of their birth to register.
And so Joseph went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to the city of David, Bethlehem in Judea, because Joseph was of the house and lineage of David. He went to register with Mary, his espoused wife, who was pregnant.
Stars go blind. Reading 2. While they were there, the time came for her delivery. She gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She put him in a simple cloth wrapped like a receiving blanket and laid him in a feeding trough for cattle because there was no room for them at the inn.
Shepherds in the area, living in the fields and keeping night watch by turns over their flock. The angel of God appeared to them, and the glory of God shone around them. They were very much afraid.
The angel said to them, "You have nothing to fear. I come to proclaim good news to you, news of great joy to be shared with the whole people. Today in David's city, a Savior, the Messiah, has been born to you. Let this be a sign to you. You'll find an infant wrapped in a simple cloth, lying in a manger."
Came upon the midnight clear.
With all the Advent ornaments you made this year from your kits. So now it is time, if you have your ornaments, to go ahead and let's spend a few minutes decorating the trees that are lit up in the front of the church. Come on, come help me.
For a miracle, the heart longs for a little bit of hope. Oh, come, Emmanuel. A child prays for peace on earth, and she's calling out from a sea of hurt. Oh, come, Emmanuel. And can you hear the angels singing, glory to the light of the world, tears of a mother, a baby's cry is the sound of love. Come down, Emmanuel. He is the song of the suffering. He is Messiah, the Prince of Peace, has come. He has come, Emmanuel. Glory
was a multitude of the heavenly host with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom God's favor rests."
Shepherds said to one another, "Let's go straight to Bethlehem and see this event that God has made known to us." They hurried and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in the manger. Once they saw this, they reported what they had been told concerning the child. All who heard about it were astonished at the report given by the shepherds.
Treasured all these things and reflected on them in her heart. The shepherds went away glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, just as they had been told.
Peace, peace, peace on earth and good will to all. This is the time for joy. This is the time for love.
Silent night, everyone. Merry Christmas. Good night.